I want to share this little story with you. It's about two young men. One of them was a Christian boy, and he just loved the Lord with all his heart and soul. The other boy, he was an atheist, and he wasn't concerned about nothing pertaining to religion. And as they grew up, the little Christian boy held on to God. And he was so faithful, they made him a deacon in his church down home. The other boy got tired of the country and he headed for the big city. He was going to have a good time. And one night, this atheist-minded boy was out in the bars having a ball. And he became the victim of mistaken identity. Somebody walked up in the bar and stabbed him in his chest. They rushed the boy to the intensive care unit at the local hospital. While the interns were working on him to try to save his life, he looked up. He said, "Doctor, would you do me a favor? Look in my wallet. There's a phone number of a friend of mine. I want you to call him and tell him to come on. I need him now." The doctor went to his wallet, got the number out, and went and made the call. When the doctor came back to the bed, he looked at the boy. The boy said to him, "Did you get it?" Doctor says, "Yes, I did." Boy said, "Well, what did he say?" He said, "He told me to tell you to hold on. Help was on the way." And the boy began to cry. Doctor said, "Well, what are you crying about? That's good news." The atheist boy looked up and said to him, he said, "Doc, it just dawned on me. I don't have nothing to hold on to. If you're living your life in the wrong way, if you're going on the downward road, if I was you, I'd find something to hold on to. Now, I wouldn't hold on to my money, because money has wings and it flies away. I wouldn't hold to some friends, because I've had some friends let me down when I really needed them. But I'd hold to God's unchanging hand." Can you say, "I'm holding to God's unchanging hand"? Oh, yes, I am. When I thought about this, I wanted it quiet to let you folk all around the country know what we have been doing. If you haven't been doing what we've been doing, you better start doing this. This is what you ought to do. You ought to. Yeah. said, well, why are you holding on? This is why.
Time.